To achieve our goal, we plan to attract serious investments from Russian and foreign companies and environmental funds. Our universal task is to preserve our planet's environment. The Black Sea is one of the Russian Federation's main assets. The Crimean Peninsula and the shores of the Krasnodar territory are washed by its waters. The Black Sea is connected with the ocean through the narrow Bosporus and Dardanelles. This is the most important economic route and a tourist attraction center. However, despite the attractiveness and importance of the Black Sea, a serious danger is hidden in its water. At depths of more than 200 meters, there is no activity. The lifeless area begins to fill all of surrounding space and goes deep down to the bottom. The reason for this is a lack of oxygen and the hydrogen sulfide contained in the seawater at these depths. This feature of the sea was discovered as a result of a Russian expedition in 1890. Further studies have shown that about 90% of the volume of the Black Sea water is saturated with hydrogen sulfide. Hydrogen sulfide is a toxic gas, which is dangerous for all life in high concentrations. Therefore, nothing can survive in the poisonous layers except rare species of anaerobic bacteria. In the pre-industrial era, the balance of the oxygen and hydrogen sulfide layers in the Black Sea was maintained naturally, thanks to chemical and biological processes. But since the start of vigorous activity utilizing the sea's resources, its coast, organic and toxic substances began to flow into the sea with wastewaters. As a result, the delicate balance was upset. The amount of hydrogen sulfide in Black Sea waters is growing each year. Scientific expeditions show that its content in the deep layers has increased by 30 to 40% since the 1970s. The main sources of hydrogen sulfide are the decomposition of animal and plant remains, bacterial activity, inflows from tectonic faults and oil-bearing layers, and thermal springs. Pollution of the sea as a result of human activity exacerbates the problem by reducing the oxygen concentration in the upper layers and causing the expansion of the hydrogen sulfide area. Sea flora and fauna suffer from this, and all this can ultimately lead to disastrous results if nothing is done to change the negative trends. The Black Sea is one of the southern areas of the Russian Federation, and with an extended coastline along which are a number of resorts and other recreational sites. Accordingly, one important task is to maintain the quality of the coastal marine environment. During the 1980s and 1990s, the main anthropogenic factor was industrial and agricultural effluents, which led to additional phytoplankton production and, as a result, to additional hydrogen sulfide production in deep waters, increasing reserves by at least 30% during that period. Currently, the main anthropogenic impact is recreational activity in the form of a significantly increased number of vacationers on the Black Sea coastal strip. Of course, this will not happen all at once. There will be no global outbreak. The pollution process will persist for many decades, so it is important to stave off the point of no return before it is too late. The hydrogen sulfide threat was once considered the main problem for Black Sea countries, but now it seems that everyone has forgotten about it. But the danger that hydrogen sulfide will completely fill the clean zone and turn the Black Sea into a lifeless source of toxic fumes remains, which in turn poses a global environmental problem. Unfortunately, there are currently no real means to clear the sea depths of hydrogen sulfide, or at least reduce its concentration. They have not yet been invented. To prevent the slow killing of the Black Sea, it is necessary to publicize this problem and gather the best minds from around the world into one place to jointly work out the entire technological process and find rational solutions to the problem. Eco Energia of the Black Sea, autonomous non-commercial organization, is going to be one of the first to solve the problems faced by the regional environment and the planet in general. For this purpose, the organization plans to attract investment to create an experimental research center on the coast or in the sea. Eco Energia of the Black Sea strategy is built on supporting scientific developments regarding the safe production and processing of hydrogen sulfide and the purification of the Black Sea. The first joint project with the innovative startup Depth Energy will begin implementation in the near future. The project's main feature is the rational use of hydrogen sulfide by producing an environmentally friendly fuel, hydrogen. The leading Russian and world institutions specializing in this issue will be brought in. Hydrogen sulfide in the Black Sea is not only a worldwide problem, but also an opportunity to create and develop an entire scientific field and energy industry. Investments in the project can not only contribute to developing science in general, but also yield huge returns. It will be possible to create an institute that will unite the minds of scientists, develop processes and new technologies to decompose hydrogen sulfide, and more. Eco Energia does not seek competition. The organization offers cooperation to all those who seek knowledge and discovery, for whom science and development is the most important tool for achieving the goal of preserving a clean planet for posterity. By joining forces, we will find a way out of this difficult situation. If it is important for the planet, it is important for us. We believe our mission is to harness science and technology for the betterment of a clean planet. We simply must do this for the sake of future generations on the entire continent.